Before I start the discussion on the system, I would like to introduce myself.
My name is D.K. Pandey. I am working in the business communication, Dubai, as an application and customer support engineer. And this is the my contact detail for the Dubai event. I will available in the email. Through the training, we are going to discuss about the 4200 system. Throughout the training, I will discuss what is the application. Means first point, it will be based in the introductions, like what is the equipment, how we can use the system. Second point, it will be based on the application of the system, how we can use this equipment for the different applications. Third point, what is the specifications, what is our working range. Third, a scope of the work. A scope of the work means we are going to discuss what will be our experiment, how we are using, what meaning of the 2 pro, 4 pro, and how we can relate these things. And over all operations, what is the capacity of the equipment. And the last point, this is called the maintenance, basic maintenance. This 4200 is called SCS. SCS means semiconductor characterization system. This equipment have the broad range of the application, and it's capable to do the any kind of application related to the semiconductor. Any kind means, generally, we can use to characterize the resistance, BJT, MOSFET, and different kind of application it can be used. And it depends how we are using. In the electrical characterizations, it's based on the 2 pro and 4 pro. In the next slide, we'll discuss what is the advantage and disadvantage of the using 2 pro and the 4 pro method in our applications. Next, if you discuss what is the basic application, where this equipment are used in the industry, research purpose, and the laboratory, then it's used for the device research and the material science of the semiconductor. Second, it's used for the failure test, reliability of the materials. And the nanotechnology, MEMS technology, generally people they are using for this equipment and the research applications. After the solar cell, photovoltaic materials and photovoltaic device for preparation, they are using for characterize the systems. Nanotechnology, MOSFET, BJT, and the many more application it's used for the characterize the our material and device. Next, about the system. If you discuss how our system is looking, then system is have the very few the pre-requirement list, like to operate the system. Then basically we require the 2 points to operate the system. One is called the power requirement, and the second point is the standard table to keep our equipment there. This is the, they have the 2 part. One is the front part, other is the back part. If you discuss this, it will be look physically, it will be look like that, the systems. This part is called the display part. Here we can access and control the input power and input voltage, how we are giving. The second, this is called, we can adjust the brightness of the screen. And fourth point is, either we can turn off the system and turn off the system. This power switch and the disk indicator, it will be so like, have you put any disk inside or not? This is the LED indicators. Next, about the interlock. Interlock means the systems can be operate up to the high voltage also. That time, for the safety purpose, they have the one interlock. Generally, the interlock, if you are using the system the beyond of the 20 volt, then this LED, it will be show here, like its interlock is activated. Interlock, without your permissions, it cannot go the 20 volt just for the safety purpose, and you can increase the voltage range also, just is required the backside there, the one short circuit to making, after that it can go beyond of the 20 voltage. Next, if you discuss about the back panel, rear panel of the system, they have the huge options here, but you describe one by one and how we can use this this part for our applications and how to control the systems. First part, this is, we are using the one fan here. Fan it's using to make the cool to the controller. Second point, here they have the two fuse in case suppose the some short circuit happen, yeah, the some voltage fluctuation, yeah, if you are drawing the more current inside, there is the some outside, there is the some short circuit and chance for the shock to the end user, that time automatically it will be get fused. And the back side they have the two USB option, either you can use for the mouse or keyboard. Even they have the option for the LAN connection, GPIB connections, and after that we can extend the monitor also. Suppose if you are not happy with this given monitor, then you can extend this monitor by help of the bigger monitor. They have to extend this communication port for extend the monitors. As I said, there is the one option for the interlock. Interlock means if you want to work beyond of the 20 volt, there is the one standard circuit to just activate your high voltage application. Then you have to make the interlock circuit so that it can go beyond of the 20 volt. After that, this is called the GPIB connection. GPIB connection is the responsible. Either suppose you want to communicate this system by help of the lab view. Some people very expert in the lab view and making the program. But for me, like is, I believe it's very complex to doing the complex program to use the system. Then I not prefer this lab view programming and the applications. But this is the only purpose. If you're very good in the programming, then you may connect and you can go for the programming. Sorry. Yeah. And the last point, this is part is called the SMU part. SMU means source measurement unit. This source measurement unit is responsible. Either you can source the current or you can source the voltage. Source means, suppose if you have your device and the all electrical device is depend on the either voltage and current. Then suppose you want to give the some voltage to your device, then by help of this source measurement unit, you can apply the voltage and you can measure the current. And you can apply the current, you can measure the voltage, and you can do the both work together. It's up to your applications. And here we have the four SMU, source measurement unit, and the next point is called the CV unit. It will be installed here, in between here, and we have to use this CVU unit also. CVU is applicable to make the characterizations of the capacitive measurements. And here they give him the one external ground common connection. We understand how we can use this sense line and everything. Okay, this the last discussion, it was the best of the small architecture of the system, how it look like, what is the option they have. Next about the system. Inside the software, if you open the system first time, they will show this four or five this option. This is called KIT, KCON, KULT, KX, and suppose if you have purchased in the future pulse generator or pulse module, then one more software it will be shown. Then only we are going to work on this KIT software. This is our end user application software. The next is applicable only. Either it applicable only for the configuration of the system, making the some hardware changes, scanning and other purpose. This KIT means the Kathle Interface Test Environment. This software only we can use for the characterize our system, record the data, making the saving, changing the anything we can use by help of this software only. This KCON means the Kathle Configuration Unit is required. Suppose if you are in the future, if you are upgrading the system, in your changing the hardware and removing the hardware, that time this part is required to upgrade, calibrate and testing the systems. Next about this Kathle User Library Tool. This library tool generally the manufacturer supplying the one extender experiment. Yeah, then the 80% your research, it will be 95%, it will become under this extender library tools. Suppose if you want to do the advanced applications, then this equipment have the manual near about the 2000
pesos. Library is installed in the unit.
It's already come with the installed.
Already, it's installed already.
Already. But only we are going to work it here. Just explaining what is the use of this software because it will be shown on the screen of your system. Next, this is called the external control interface, which already discussed. The one more important point, like how to launch the software, is very simple. When we turn on the system, automatically it will be open this KIT software. In case, suppose if you disconnected, any case you cut the software, then it's very simple. You have either you can double click from your desktop, and you can go to the program, you can find the KIT, and you may open this one. Next, about this is a very important display point here. We need to understand how to use this software. In the first, after opening the software, it will be show the basic this display. In the left side of the display, it will show the 4 terminal, 3 terminal, and 2 terminals measurements. Then, according to our application, we can select from here. Yeah, either suppose if you want to make the dedicated measurement, then you can make your own project also. But what the other people they are doing, they are taking this library file from the manufacturer, and they are making the copy to the other places, and generally they are opening from there, and they are doing the measurements. Suppose I want to do the resistance measurement, that time I'll just select this point. They'll just select this resistance 2 terminal. After that, we have to select physically where I have placed my probe, test probe. Then, according to your conditions, we can apply the voltage. Suppose I want to apply the voltage -1 to +1, and we can apply the voltage. And what we want to do, suppose I want to calculate the 2-point resistance, then we can go for the resistance. In the same applications, if you want to do the capacitive, then we take the cable from the capacitive unit, and we know for the capacitor, we require the 2 probe for the testing. We put the 2 probe there, and we will make the measurements. Next, about the same like the three terminals like is emitter, collector, and the base. The same, we place the 3 points, and after that we can make the characterization as per our application. But the approach is always same. Just we have to click our applications from here, and we have to place the probe there properly, and we be sure our probe is placed there in the proper way. Even we discussed during the physical training also how we can identify. And the same if we are doing the 4 probe measurements, then we can use this 4-point measurements. This is the